Okay, so now I have to calculate the right hand side of my equation. So first of all, a plus b, that is 0 plus 0, which is 0. Then again 0 plus 0, 0 plus 1, 0 plus 1, 1 plus 0, 1 plus 0, and 1 and 1. Then I have to calculate a plus c. So this is a and this is c. So 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1. Now time to multiply them. 0.0 is 0, 0.1 is 0, 1.0 is 0, 1.1 is 1, 1.1 is 1, 1.1 is 1, 1 and 1. So if you examine the last and this, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th column. So you would see that the left hand side is equal to right hand side. I advise you to make the truth tables of these so you get the better understanding and in your logical questions, these identities comes in handy. You can use them to simplify your Boolean expressions. In the later exercises, we would see how we can do that. But everyone must go through all these identities. The last thing I want to talk about today is actually binary addition, which is actually a core concept in computers, the core function of all the processors. The processors are able to add. So the 2-bit addition is one of the main functions of your processors. But how we actually implement the 2-bit addition in computers? If you refer to the page number 273 of your books, you will see something called a half adder circuit. A half adder circuit is a circuit which is used to implement the 2-bit addition. The diagram representation of a half adder circuit would be A and B going into the adder circuit, and the result is going to be the sum bit and a carry bit. This is your half adder circuit. Now, how is it implemented? Let us consider the truth table of 2-bit addition first. What I have is A, my first bit, and B. And let's fill them up like this. Now, the result, the sum of my A plus B addition, in this case it is going to be 0 plus 0. And in this case 0 plus 1, 1 plus 0. But right here when I'm trying to add two ones, 1 plus 1, it is going to become 2. And you already remember from your binary addition lessons that you have to write 0 and 1 is carry. So for the sum bit, you have a 0, and for the carry bit, you have a 1. See, in the previous 3 addition, there was no carry bit generated. The carry bit was 0. But here, when you are trying to add 1 and 1, the carry bit will be generated, so you have to account for that as well. So this table simply guides us how the half adder circuit works. How we can implement the half adder circuit in our computers? If you are looking closely at these two columns, you might remember that this whole thing is an and this whole thing can be XOR. Now, how we can implement the circuit? Now that it is quite straightforward, we can simply implement an XOR gate and an AND gate to implement the half adder circuit. Let's try and do this. I have my inputs of A and B, and I can make an XOR, and this XOR's output is going to be my sum bit, and then I can also make an AND gate here. And that AND gate's output is going to be my carry bit. So this is one way to represent your half adder circuit. But as you know that we don't actually like to use diverse gates, variety of gates in our circuitry. Our computers are so good at doing the same thing over and over again that we used to represent every circuit in terms of a single logic circuit. In this case, we would try to represent all these gates using the NAND gate. We have done that in our AS as well, and the diagram of representing all the sum and the carry bits is there on your books page number 273 as well. So go through that. Try to cover the page, chapter number 18 till page number 273. And in my Monday's lesson, we would talk about the full adder circuit and sequential circuits. The combinational circuits, the half adder and full adder, they are used to actually do the mathematical calculations. The sequential circuits, the SR flip-flops and JK flip-flops, they are actually used to retain the memory. They are used to make the memory circuits, which would be the next topic of my lecture. Thank you very much. Stay safe until then. Allah Hafiz.